Here we go again, back with more Motorsport Mania, episode 24. Yeah, this will be 24, isn't it? No, that's one season too far. Episode 19 now, I believe. Yeah, 19 makes more sense. I don't know what I'm talking about. I actually think it's 24 because we did 10 episodes season 1, so it is 24. Just stop me talking. Okay, last time we got a pretty good result in the second race, got second, and I believe, what did we get else? Sixth or something like that? Where's the calendar? That is the calendar in Munich. Second and sixth, yeah. Gave 34 points. Garuda didn't get that many points because even though they won the race, the other driver did not finish. So they only got 1 point. And for Eastwood, they got 16th and 9th place, which is a really bad result. So they didn't get many points either. Of course, we are looking for first in the championship. We are currently second in drivers and third here. But we're only 4 points behind Garuda in first. It's going to be really close, especially the last race is probably going to decide most of what actually happens here. So we are starting to build a new test track here. It'll be done probably around winter, so we can start using that for season 5 here. Car condition, yeah, it doesn't really matter, and Ingledew won the race. So let's just move forward a little bit. I don't think there's much to check out during this race here. Okay, so we have a vote here. It is on medium length practice sessions, which I will definitely say yes to. I know it will not benefit low quality teams, benefit average quality teams, but I would like to just have that 3 more minutes, so I'll use only one vote for it. Actually, I might just abstain because... No, I'm going to use one vote for it and we'll just see if it goes through. I don't think it will. Let's go through it a little bit faster. 4, 5. Oh, okay, we got it. So I could have just abstained the vote and I would have been fine, but yeah, I got what I wanted, so I'm pretty much happy about that. Now it's just going to the race and I'll go through the practice myself. Okay, we got a little dilemma here. Tom Woodbridge, mechanic, I think our oldest mechanic, the guy who's been here for a really long time, where is he at? The worst one as well, yes. His contract runs out in 4 months, so he's the biggest deal. He's mechanic for Max Porter as well. We could fire him. We could fine him and lose German happiness. I can't afford to lose German happiness, so I actually have to fire him, I think. So that's not good. Yeah, you probably knew that already, but that is not good for us. So now we need to sign a new mechanic. Just let's get scouting already here. 3 and a bit star maybe. Kenny Harding here. Good at pit stops. I want him. Let's try and sign Kenny Harding for the team. Pretty important. So it'll give you 56 end of next year. Nice sign-on fee of 150. Bonus size is important. If Max Porter wins the race, I'll give you 72,000. Good, let's just go a week forward and see how how that changes everything. So we have a little renegotiation here. It's not going to mean he's not going to sign before the race, which is a bit annoying. He just wants more money than what I've given him here. So we go up to 71. What is the max we can give him to see? Okay, I'll go 66 instead, just because I feel like that's almost the maximum we can give him before that. So let's go with this, and we'll go to the race now, where of course we'll choose a new sponsor for the race. I'll go second above this time. I'm risking it. I want that extra 200,000. Parts doesn't need to change, so I'll go through the practice now and I'll see you guys again at the race. Okay, so we're at the race now. Of course, goal is second above. We've pretty much switched the state because we need to get second above anyway to probably not get fired at this point. Didn't get level 1 in intermediate tires, which is a bit annoying because I think it's going to rain at some point during the race. So let's just look at it here. Okay, this is actually really interesting to see. So the question is now, is it worth doing the first 2 laps or so on soft tires to stay out intermediates? Or should you just start on super soft tires? Really low amount of fuel. We need a little bit more down. A little bit more downforce, I think. Yeah, a little bit more downforce. Okay, rest should be fine here. We'll start on super soft tires and we'll only go 4 laps of fuel. This is very, very risky. So we'll see how it works out. So we'll go in the pit after 3 laps, I think. So this is... I'm probably going to regret this decision, but I want to do it. It's a good strategy, but I don't think anyone else would go with this small amount of fuel in the car. So Paul, I think, starts in 7th to 8th position. I think he moves up a little bit after a good result last time. So he starts in... Oh, actually, not even top 8. 9th, 10th? 9th place. So 9th and 19th, I believe, we start in. Which is not bad. So, let's go to the other side here. And he gets a terrible start, sadly enough, on these soft tires with a really empty car as well. There shouldn't be enough much fuel in it, so he should actually be pretty fast on this car. So he dropped to 12th though, so definitely not a good start. So kind of holding up a few drivers behind him at the moment. Reyes in 18th. Porter down to 14th now. 15th. This is not good, honestly. This is not good at all right now. The start that both of my drivers have gotten. At least Engel though is still in 20th. But John Statier is up to 7th already. How is he up to 7th already? Wow. Okay. 17th and 18th as a race will now overtake. Overtake Porter. Up to 16 now already. Engel also overtakes Porter here. Porter just going really, really slow for some reason. He's down to last now. From 9th to last in one lap. Gets past two riders again here, Mauro Silva and Abeloa. As I think a race there gets overtaken maybe. Oh, and actually he overtakes Sevilla. So good to see there. No rain yet, which is a bit worrying for me. I might have should have put one more lap of fuel in the car. But I just thought I wanted to be as fast as possible in the first couple of laps. I don't really think it's worked out, but Alvarez is at least moving up in the field now. Porter loses a position more to Abeloa of all people. Not the person you should use position to right now. 13th Alvarez. At the moment, just got past Floridi. Okay, they all pitted there. I feel like that's a lap too early to pit. So we'll pit in here as well for intermediate tires. Fuel options. Fill up the car completely. Parts are looking fine. Fast pit stop. Pit here again. Intermediate tires. Fast pit stop again. Tires have been changed, yes. Okay. We'll just go down to high, just because I'm a bit worried that we won't make it around this lap here if we don't. So let's just speed this up here and go to the end of the lap. And we'll see where we'll come out after the pit stop here. I don't think we've gained as much as I wanted to gain here during this really short soft stint. There's not really enough water out on track anyways to the point where I feel like it was worth going in the pit the lap before here. So a lot of people did not go in the pit. Paul of course is going to come out probably in last place since he got held up a lot. I actually come up behind Ingledew. How did I come up behind Ingledew? Alvarez now in 14th behind Ingledew on the meter tires. Actually, okay, of course a lot of them pitted and they're listening way ahead of me. But I feel like I pitted on the right lap at least. Is anyone behind me? Mauro Silva behind me in 20th place. It's the only one from the Eastwood. But you see Ingledew is catching up fast to the driver's head. We gained a lot just on that lap there. You see I'll be up to 5th now, but Ingledew is in 4th at the moment. The riders who pitted early on the intermediate tires have really gained from this. Porter came out in the middle of that bunch, which is really annoying. If he came out just like a few seconds earlier there, or if I pitted him a lap earlier maybe, then at least they didn't get pitted at the same time, it might have been better. But yeah, I did not. So that's my own fault. Cohen is still in 5th. I'm hoping that he at least will catch us up to the front 4, so... Oh yes! I know I shouldn't be happy about this, but Ingledew of all people crashing is the best thing that could happen in this series for me. He's leading the championship and he's riding for the best team in the entire race as well, so... Oh, also Salate crashed as well. He won the race that I got second in first time. I think it was race number 5 he won. Of course, this is race 7, so that's 2 races ago. That's the first race of the last episode. I should have won that race. So that's a pretty good competitor out now. I feel like the 3 riders ahead of me now, Sicily is a pretty decent car in third place. And Nightingale also. But that's a rider or two I probably should beat. Sevilla in 6th place is a good driver, so I'm a bit worried about him. Porter still in 14th, sitting behind Liao at the moment. Oh, I almost took them on the outside there as they were battling for second place. Kinda happy that Abeloa is behind me now, not Sevilla, because Abeloa is kinda holding Sevilla up at this point. Porter's got overtaken by Cruz. Almost being overtaken by Mauro Silva now as well. There's an overtake ahead of me now, yes. Sicily has overtaken Nightingale, so now I'll pressure Nightingale instead here, as I do take third place from Nightingale. Sevilla is now in fifth, we're up to second now, so we're actually in the objective zone here. Good thing about it is there's big enough difference between my two drives now that I can put them in at the same lap and it'll come out fine. I haven't really got a strategy for what I'm going to do here, but I think I'm actually going to go repeat it in at the end of lap 3, so this is the 6th lap we're on these tires. I'm still going high actually. Come on, get past him up front here. Alvarez, get up to first now. Oh, I'm right behind him. Avalor is in third now, as a lot of people are pissed. This is Nightingale. Porter up to 11th now. Came out ahead of the riders who pitted, thankfully. So it's not that far behind. Oh, take first. Yes, we take first now. I think Rogers will probably pit on this lap here. He did not pit, so we'll try and use this to pull away a little bit from them all. 10th place, Porter now up to 6th, as Abeloa, El Sala, Johnson, Tia, and Cruz pitted there. So we'll go in this lap here, I think, with Alvarez. He'll go onto New Zealand's media tires. They'll last for however long they'll last. I'll put in 9 laps of fuel actually. Parts are looking fine. Fast pit stop. Same with Porter here. We'll put him here in here as well. Also 9 laps of fuel, or 8 laps more on top of what he had before. Parts are again looking fine here, and again a fast pit stop. And they'll probably come out, Porter will probably come out in 17th, 18th place. And Alvarez will come out in probably 5th. Unless, I don't know, he'll probably come out on 10th actually, because that's the first one where he hasn't pitted. So if he comes out ahead of 10th place, that's a good sign, because then the pit stop has gone well. So no problems, at least with the pit stop. Come out ahead of Nightingale, please. He does come ahead of Nightingale. That's very good for us. Means we have pretty much the lead now. Rogers will come, Porter will come out in last? Yeah, he'll come out in last place. So, pretty different results. He also had a problem with the pit stop as well, so not really totally his fault, but still. At least he has better tire wear than everyone else has now right now. So I think I'm actually going to go a little bit high. Attack overtake with Porter. Still play a little bit safer here with Alvarez, because, he is in a better position right now. I don't know why I'm clicking on Igloo. So Silva's Vinanen and Latinen go in the pit here. They still come out and way ahead of them all. Antonov still hasn't pitted in second, so I think that's good that he's kind of plucking Silva's now off. We have better tire wear than all of the other guys in top 5 anyway at the moment. We'll see Port up to 16th now. He's overtaking at least Valdez and Liao. And he's kind of pushing now, because I want him to pit a little bit earlier maybe onto a set of dry tires. Maybe 8 laps to go, 7 laps to go. Whenever it's the right amount, so I might as well just push on these tires. That's really my strategy at the moment. Also, I can also just push the engine here with Alvarez. He seems to be fine on all parts here. Maybe rearing, but that doesn't really depend so much on the engine. Ray still in first, second is Silvas, Sevilla in third. Johnstadt here down 8th place, so looking at Garuda then 8th and didn't finish 19th. And Eastwood are in 15th and 3rd, we are in 1st and 13th right now. Up to 12th now as Cruz pits in here. Does he go on dry tires? Does he go on dry tires? That's the question. If he goes on tires, he doesn't go into early. If he went on intermediate tires that I did there, that's a big mistake in my book. I don't agree with that decision at all. Paul are still really pushing his tires here. I'll also push my tires a little bit more, as I think it's getting closer and closer to the point where we also need to pit in here. Now the silver pits again onto a new intermediate tires. Again, bad move. I haven't actually looked again, but yeah, it is going to dry out for the final 6-7 laps. So I'm increasing my gap now with Alvarez up front here. Porter down to 12th again. Gets overtaken. 11th now. No one pitted there. I think I should have pit this lap, but lap later on. It's damp now. I probably should pit here. So if I pit in here, I'll have 6 laps to go. We'll put in 8.5 laps of fuel. We'll go on a set of soft tires. We could go super soft as well, but I'll go on soft. And we'll do a fast pit stop. We have tire changed on, yes. Fuel has been filled, so I think that would be fine, actually. And then you can just push those tires all that you want to the end. So we'll see. He'll probably come out in around 4th, 5th position here. Okay, Sevilla pitted as well. Silvas did not pit. I'll put in Porter here as well. Onto a setup super soft instead. So we'll do a little bit different here. Still have to do 8 laps because it's still 6 laps. Just because the lead isn't on the next lap right now, and he isn't. So we'll put 7 laps of fuel in his car. And a fast pit stop here. Let me just double check. I don't think I missed something. I just had a feeling that I missed something, so I just wanted to change it again. Fast pit stop, okay. That should be fine now. Actually, Alvarez comes out in second place ahead of Jonas Tartier, Rodgers and Latinen here. So good pit stop overall. Porter is now down to 16th place, 17th place as he comes out behind Mauro Silva as well. Second currently for Alvarez. Hoping that I don't lose too much time to Silva's out in front here on these dry tires. That they soon will start being faster. Silva's did not pit again this lap. Just that here behind me pitted, Rodgers has still not pitted. I feel like I pitted maybe a lap too early. I could have stayed out a lap longer. But I was worried that everyone else would pit there. Okay, still in 11th place with Porter, so I didn't really lose that much time in front here. And now I feel like I'm pulling away. Now I feel like the dry tires are faster at this point. Yeah, so in first now again, as Silva's pitted and Rodgers pitted here onto super soft tires, both of them probably. But yeah, they actually, I think, gained time on staying out longer. So I should have pitted one lap later than I did. And that would probably have been the perfect point. Would be nice to have Porter go past Abeloa here. But with 4 laps to go, I feel like with 8.5 seconds to Silva's, even though it's going down because he has some super soft tires and they're fresher, I still feel like we have the advantage here and we should win this race with 3 laps to go. Fuel should be a no problem here. Maybe starting to be a problem here for Porter. 3 laps to go here and yeah, he only has 3 laps of fuel left, so he definitely can't go that fast anymore. 6 seconds now with 2 laps to go. I still think we got this under control. I'm not worried at all, honestly. I'm a little bit worried because it's going down, of course. So you always get a little extra worried here, but I think this should be under control. Sevilla take 3rd. John starts here 6th place. Mauro Silva down 16th. So we're beating him as well with Porter. The guys who pit onto the meter tires, we're gaining and we didn't even lose time here that much. We lost like 2/10 of a second compared to last lap. So not really a big deal at all. I think Porter's on the pressure now from Antonov. Yeah, he got overtaken, Porter. Not really at the end of the world. We got too high again for the final lap here. A bit of a risk, but I'm willing to take that 5 second gap. I think this is our first race win in like 10-15 episode or so. It's been really long. Let's race win. Yeehaw! Champagne time indeed. I'm pretty sure we'll now go to the top of the individual standings, and also Porter picking 12th is pretty much the best team effort again today. Actually, Fluid and Latin will probably take 1st in Constructors today, which is annoying because that's really what counts for the chairman. So we'll probably only take 2nd there. But we'll take 1st overall in standings. Maybe that will help hit the mood of my chairman a little bit. Latin is out of fuel in 7th though. Ah, that's annoying. This is one of the drivers who probably would beat us today. And we take 12th as well. A lot of drivers ran out of fuel at the end. As well as Porter also. He pretty much ran out of fuel as well. So we finished 1st and 12th. First race win in a while. Really, really, really good performance from Alvarez here. Was the best drive on the day. Started 19th, still ended up winning. Porter not had a great start, but still managed to get some points home. Happy to see Ingledew not finish. not to be mean, but it was the best result possible for us, pretty much here. I feel like we finally got a little bit of luck on our side with her crashing out at the beginning of the race. I was really excited, and we took full advantage of it with our first race win in a while. Let's see if anyone else got the grid a little bit, so maybe Porter can get a few more points. So, where's my mouse? Can you skip on keyboard? Oh, you can't hear. Oh, there it is. And then it disappeared again. There it is. Okay. And here it gets to 11th. That's Antonov, who overtook him at the end. Got the motor 4 places. So 11th and 1st. Sipsilis took the fastest lap, so she gets 2 extra points for that. Good for her. On that 11th points, I think the best team was... What's it called? The team with Fluidi and Latinen. They finished with 17 and 14 points, that's 31. We finished with 30 points. So we got second on the day here from teams. If only Porter has been like one place better, we would have at least been tied. But sad enough, did not happen. We won our first race. It's been a while since I've seen on him. First on the cup. We're now leading the individual championship, and I'm pretty sure we should also be leading the Constructors Championship now with 5 points to each suit and 8 points down to Garuda Racing. Silva's closed up the gap a little bit. So, really happy to finally get a victory here. Hopefully we can make it 2 in a row here in the next race. So look at this. We won the race and his happiness goes up with 1% just because we finished 2nd and not 1st. At least I got 1 million. More, so at least we're earning some money back right at the moment, because we kind of need that as well. And of course next race will come up soon. I don't think there's much to do right now with the car and with HQs and everything, so we'll just answer to the dilemmas and interviews, and that's pretty much it. We got a race win bonus for morale. I don't care about this morale bonus because it's gone by the time it goes to the next race anyway. It is really stupid. Yep. Yeah, I'm just saying that the team effort, and I'm not disappointed in Max Porter. That's pretty much what I said there. Car repairs finished. I'm pretty sure we can just... They're not doing anything now, so let's just see. Here we can do the final reliability on the brakes here. We could actually also work on these spin. This can be a little bit better for Porter, but I don't really care. These are engine is all fine. Gearbox all done. Suspension is all done. So other than that, we can only really work on front wing, rear wing. Reliability. So I don't care too much about it. I'm just not going to work on it. Design parts, we can design these brakes here, but they were all risk level, wasn't it? Yeah, they were all risk level 1. So unless you can you I don't know if you can build them and then next season they lose the risk level on them, but you still get the performance. Is that a thing? I don't actually know, but I'm not going to risk it anyway, so I won't build any parts more this season. Nothing much happening there. Of course, we're still hoping to get promoted, but it seems more and more unlikely. Okay, I almost forgot about it. We had the mechanic that we had to sign. So he has either renegotiations or he has accepted the offer now. Let's see, terms not met. He wants even more. You know what, I need a new mechanic, so let's just sign him. I know he'll accept this one. If he doesn't accept this one, he's stupid. Stupid. So let's just go to the 6 days more, and I think he'll accept this offer. Okay, so he has finally agreed to the contract offer. He'll sign as Max Porter's mechanic for the next season. And of course, replace this temporary mechanic, a nice Gesell, I guess it is. And yeah, we'll sign him, of course, a little sign-on fee, and he'll cost us a bit more money than the old mechanic we had, actually. And now, at minus 478, have we lost a sponsor? Okay, we have lost a sponsor, that's part of the reason why. But was it really that much expense more expensive than the old mechanic we had? It's only like 70,000 per race. Huh. I guess it was. Or maybe we just had a really good sponsor before. I don't know. I'm hoping we're gonna use sponsor offer for that slot because that's one of the good sponsors. Okay, there it actually is. Just as I was speaking about it, 3 new offers available. This one is the one we had before, 350 per race. That's 3.25 million in total. He would get 1 million for 6 races, so he would get 1.68 races, so this is still the best one. Taking that, that should lower the loss per race a lot now. Of course, we're still earning profit as long as we get the results we want, and as long as we get the good, nice trial bonus, and we're still saving 1 million per race for next season's car, so everything's actually looking really good now for the economy, I would believe, even if we are technically losing money every race. So we're at the Portuguese Grand Prix now. Again, we're going to go second place because that's really what we need. We got second last 3 races at least. So I'm kind of planning on continuing that trend. Let's just go into practice now and I'll see you guys again at the race. Okay, we're at the race now. We got level 2 in both things this time, medium tires and race trim. Not going to take any of the pit stop things, just going pure performance based here as we really need it. We need a little bit more towards, I think, don't know if it's under the oversteer. Before we had, okay, here now we have good. So I think we need a little bit more of understeer on the car. So we'll go like this. A tire choice will go on. Is it going to rain at all? No. 25 laps. And how much fuel can we put in the car? We can put 10 laps of fuel in the car. So we go slow with... We'll go fast with Porter then. If we go slow with any of them, we'll go slow with... what's it called? Yeah, the auto driver. I can't remember the name right now. 6 laps of fuel on the soft tires. Also a little bit more understeer here. And tire choice, medium tires for that extra performance. 10 laps of fuel in the car. And you want to go 9 laps on these. I don't think it'll happen because there'll be a lot of lockups in the first couple of stints. And most likely it'll happen to me as well. So hopefully it'll turn out all right still. But we have two different, very different strategies here for our two drivers. Trying to two-stop strategy with Alvarez and a three-stop, maybe more, with Porter. Come on, Porter, get it to start. We are last, of course, Alvarez, so we can't really lose anything from the start. That's the Otex English do. So that's at least nice to see. We're not last with her anymore. Porter, I think, lost the position or two. I don't remember what position started. I think it started 9th or 10th. I think he started in 9th place. I think it was 12th overall before, so I think he's in 9th place. So he's already lost like 2, 3 positions now. And he's battling with Zarate here. And no, that's actually El Sala he's battling with. El Sala and Artica is definitely a car we should beat. Oh, bit of outbreaking battle there. Almost caused a lockup, I think, for both of our drivers. Alvarez up to 17th at the moment. Even not going that fast on her tires. She's actually got a good start. Porter's kind of been plugged in here because he's... He couldn't really get on the right racing line. Still not on the right racing line. He's taking some very awkward lines through there here. What's costing position after position at the moment. He needs to get into the right racing line here. The only guy who was worse there was Zarate. He was in a terrible racing line. Cross position to Sevilla there as he or she dived up the inside. Porter locks up on his fast soft tires. So that pretty much ruins those tires now. Mauro da Silva in 18th has caused a collision with who? Valdez? It's not Ingeloo, because Ingeloo is still moving, so I think it's Valdez and Mauro da Silva. Who's had some kind of collision. There's a bit of a gap. Maybe Ingeloo's had a collision as well, because he seems to be losing time to other races here. This is good to see one of the Garuda riders maybe in trouble already. I'm actually going to pit in Porter here as well on a new set of soft tires that he can just go fast on as well. So we'll go in 7 laps on these tires, fast pit stop, new set of softs. He'll come out alone and then he'll come up ahead of Silva's Ingeloo, Mauro da Silva and Valdez, which is all I really want here. And he can just speed on those tires for a while. So end of lap 2 he already pits here, that's really early on, of course, but Alvarez is still, I mean, he's holding on to the back of the group here. Ingeloo does pit here, so that's good to see. So he'll come out in Still 18th place, so he doesn't lose anything. Reyes has a bit of trouble keeping up with the big group ahead of him. As long as he doesn't lose too much time, he only has to do, of course, only has to do two stops. I think he'll actually be okay with this strategy here. He hasn't locked up again, and as long as he's not sitting immediately behind someone, he's definitely not going to lock up. John Stottier, an 8th for Garuda, locks up. That's good to see. Of course, he's one of the faster drivers here. I don't know if this is a good strategy, doing what I'm doing here. I'm overtaking Floridi here with some kind of mechanical issue. And Antonov as well. A few other people pitting here. Reyes comes out just behind Liao and Rodgers, who has already pitted, so not the best sign that he comes up behind two people who have already pitted. Should I let allow teammate through here? Alvarez, please. I know Paul is the second driver, but right now he's on the faster tires, I think. I think he should be faster, at least. Maybe he's not. Maybe I lost time doing that all side-by-side driving there. Yeah, I come up behind Sevilla as well. I don't think that's a good move. Sevilla was kind of close to Alvarez in the start, and now ahead. So we have 18 laps to go after this, I think. 19 laps after this lap still. That's quite a lot of time still to go. Of course, third place is already pitted. Third, fourth, fifth, and seventh already pitted. And everyone behind us has already pitted as well. So it's a bit of a weird point we had at this point. I think Porter will have to pit now. He'll come out in probably around 18th, 19th, 20th place again. On medium set of tires again. Should we do one more on softs? You know what, I'm going to do one more stint on soft tires. Just because then the last two sets of medium tires will be a little bit easier to get through. So, fast pit stop again for Porter. Porter and Mina has pitted twice. So there's definitely some different strategies we are going on to right now. Reyes up to 7th now. Porter actually out in 13th place. Not bad, actually. Still ahead of Ingledew because he's gone on these super soft tires. Really short amount of time, so he's gone really fast laps. While the other people have gone pretty slow around. Reyes is under pressure in 7th place now from John Stottier. He thankfully still has not locked up again. At the end of lap 8th now. And he has to go, of course, till the end of lap 9. So he has to do 2 more laps on these tires. He's fine in fuel level. There's no problems there. He's not really that far behind first either. So really impressed at how well he's holding on, especially with these pretty terrible tire conditions at the moment that he is working with. And now he's actually pulling a little bit away from John Stottier and Cruz behind, catching up with Sevilla and Liao ahead of him. So that's good to see, as he will go in the pit on this lap now. Fuel options will fill the car up completely again. We can go a little bit on overtake on maybe the final few laps once we realize how much fuel we have left. Almost overtaking Sevilla here on the outside, but instead I think he's not going to get overtaken by John Stottier and Cruz maybe. Yeah, but it doesn't matter. He's going in the pit here anyway. He probably cost them more time by doing that instead. So good pit stop. He'll come out behind Porter, which is okay. Porter has a pit soon anyway. Come out just ahead of, who's that? Antonov. Antonov is not on the best tire condition anyway. He's currently on conserving his tires but using a lot of fuel. So Porter in 13th now, battling with Zarate. I also get past Zarate here. I think I put Porter in this lap. Yes. 14, that's the lead. He has 15 laps to go, so we'll go 8 and 7 here. We'll just fill the car up as well. Didn't change the tire, so we need to do that. I almost forgot about that. Pit stop. Porter in here. So it doesn't hold up at race, at least. That's really the strategy I had there. Antonov also went in the pit. Come out just ahead of Ingledew. Good thing to see. We come ahead of Ingledew of all people. She locks up as well. Perfect timing that I came out just ahead of her. Good pit stop from the pit stop crew. We're in 12th place. Latin ahead of us doesn't have good tire wear. Hopefully at some point he'll pit in. First place pits in here. Of course will come out well ahead of us. I'm not really getting past a lot of drivers right now, but we move up to 10th at least. There's how many drivers ahead of us have pitted yet? Two. Nightingale and Sicilis have already pitted, so they're definitely ahead of us, since they've already pitted later. Of course, they might have still have two pit stops to go. Actually, they will only have one pit stop more to go. So, it's okay. Rogers in second pits here. I have to go a little bit slower with Porter there, I forgot about that. 10th here. So, we move up to 5th here, just ahead of Rogers. That's good to see. We only have Jungstad here and El Salad ahead of us yet, who has not pitted. Yeah, El Salad will definitely come out ahead of us, but maybe we'll come out ahead of Jungstad here at the moment. It's going to be pretty close between us maybe jumping up to 4th place now. So right, Nightingale will now take the lead. And I think we'll come out just ahead. Whew. So we have both our drivers ahead of both of the Gruda drivers right now. The Eastwood team are in 7th, and this Mauer, the silver driver, is really poor. It's down 19th. I think he or she is consistently in the bottom 5 every race. Maybe, I don't know why she's so far down there, but they're doing really poorly, the Eastwood team, the last couple of races. I think they've lost a lot of points, and we've just been doing better and better. Currently in 4th place and 10th place. Definitely not a bad result at all. So, we have to make it to the end of lap 17. So this is from now after this start line here. This is 3 more laps that our race has to do on these tires. Should be doable. Of course, just the worst tire wear of the front 4, front 7, 8, 10 riders maybe even. But I feel like it should be fine. We pit in Porter 1 lap later than we pit in Alvarez. So that's just, he has to do one more lap. That's pretty much the only way I can think about it. I know he thinks he needs to stop pushing, but he does need to stop pushing. He needs to stay at this pace here for another 2 laps. He's getting closer and closer to the end of the stint. He'll have some nice fresh tires on. There's a lot of people pitting here again. Ingelus still only in 17th place. Now she has pitted though, so she might jump up a few more positions here. But I'm keeping Jungstad here behind me on these old tires. So they're definitely not utilizing their new tires as much as I am. So this is when Alvarez will have to pit in here. Tires have been changed. Car has been fully fueled up. Fast pit stop. There's plenty of fuel to go. I probably can go overtake as well here with Paul for the final couple of laps here. He has to do, of course, 2 more laps. Still in 10th place, Porter. Battling a little bit with Vanden at the moment, but you can see now we're pulling a bit away from Alvarez as we've realized that we have enough fuel to push a little bit here before the pit stop. So in 4th now, take the pit here. Nightingale Sicilis also in the pit. We'll come out in maybe ahead of Porter, maybe behind Porter. We'll come out just ahead of Porter. Rogers came out just behind us after his pit stop before. So seeing him here now is nice to see. It means we have caught up a lot of time. 9 laps of fuel. Fast pit stop as well, we need to change the tires. I forgot about that for Porter for almost the second time in a row. Pit Porter in here, he'll probably come around in 15th, 16th place. Probably somewhere around Ingelu. Hoping that Rogers pits here maybe. Or maybe next lap. At least soon. I'm hoping that Rogers pits ahead of me here. So he's holding me up quite badly at the moment. I still come out ahead of who's that, Cruz, but I think I'm going to lose third to Jungstad here at this point because I'm being held up by Rogers in 6th. And I'm not going to go on overtake or attack to get past him. I don't want to use the extra tire wear for that. We've lost 8th places, 7th place now to Cruz as well. So definitely not what we wanted to see. El Salad in 4th still comes out ahead of us. I don't think we're going to get top 2 this time, sadly enough. It seemed like they're just a bit too far ahead. Still 7th and 10th is not actually that bad. Archer team is doing great this time, 5th and 6th. Of course, Rogers will have to pit soon. I've gone past Cruz again for 7th place, so that's not good. That's not bad. It's definitely good. Hopefully Abeloa pits here so I can get him out of the way. Rogers pitted there, so Cruz can pass me again. We're still in 7th, but now we're in 7th and 8th place with no more pit stop to do. John Sotir in 2nd, Nightingale is in 1st. John Sotir still hasn't pitted yet. I'm wondering if she wants to go to the end, as he's just going to a really late stop here. I think she should have pitted a lap or go to actually make it worth it. So this still doesn't pit. I think she's going to try and make it to the end. That is definitely a mistake in my book. I think she's not going to make it to the end of that. 4 laps to go. I don't think she has enough fuel to make it to the end. So we are in 7th and 8th now. We're going to go up to overtake now with Alvarez here. Yeah, because there's 4 laps to go and we have... Yeah, there's pretty much only 3 laps to go. 3.5 laps to go and we have 5 laps of fuel. I feel like we have enough fuel to make it to the end here. Same with Porter, of course. We have the same amount of fuel, but 1 lap less, so we could definitely have enough fuel with Porter here. That should be no worries. Jones Martí is still using quite a lot of fuel. Cruz now down to saving fuel on this straight here, so I think we'll start catching a little bit up with him, maybe. The front runners are definitely going slower and slower now as we're catching him up more and more. Shame that there isn't more laps, because then I feel like we've been in the best position. Of course, that's not really a shame, that's just how the race is strategized. Jones Martí is out of fuel now, so that's Garuda losing even more points. Seal will definitely lose position. We'll move up to 6th and 7th now. I don't think there's many other people that might lose positions here up front. I think everyone else has enough fuel to make it to the end. It's only if you can overtake someone in the final lap here. So 6th and 7th at the moment. I don't think we're going to lose any positions here. We have enough fuel with both our drivers to make it to the end. Ingledew is out of fuel, so both Garuda riders will... Oh, this is perfect. They're both messed up so bad. They're going to finish last, both of them. Wow, they're actually going to finish last. Sevilla has taken the lead from Nightingale in the final corner here. Don't think any of them have run out of fuel. They must have some different problems here. Let's see Alvarez here. I don't think he's going to overtake them. To overtake Cruz and Sipsalis here, but it's pretty close at least. He takes 6th place. Could have probably taken 5th if it was one more lap to go. Porter will take a nice 7th place finish, so definitely not a bad result for the two teams here. I actually think we'll get 2nd again. We'll only get 2nd because Arte actually got more points than us for 3rd and 8th place than we get for 6th and 7th. So we'll take 2nd in that standings again, but we are definitely increasing our lead overall constructors-wise, so we'll probably get promoted at the end of the season here. As long as we don't get fired for some reason. I don't know why we would be fired, because we're winning championship, we're winning the constructors championship, but at least our chairman is still unhappy with us. I feel like that's something that definitely needs to be changed in this game. So our race finished in 6th place, Porter in 7th. 2-stop strategy ended up working pretty well. We had a really weird strategy with Porter, of course, doing the first 3 stints on super softs. Ended up with doing 4 stops, most of anyone in the top 14, but still ended up actually working out pretty well, finishing him in 7th place. So I'm not that disappointed about the result. Of course, a little bit unlucky with the first soft stint. If we could have gone like 4-5 laps here, then 4-5 laps more. So have 2 5 stints on soft tires and then done the same on medium tires, maybe it would have been faster. But I feel like we did the best with what we got offered. Let's see if anyone got demoted a little bit so we move up even higher in the standings. Scrutineering, no risk of rule break for us, of course, since we haven't cheated at 1 point. Still finished 6th and 7th, and Nightingale take fastest lap. Ingledew and Jens Martí finished last and 2nd to last, and Eastwood finished 1st to last. So all my competitors went in the bottom 3, and the only other one was in, 1st, pretty much. So 20 points, but we still get 29 points. Arte get 18 plus 13, that's 31 points. So they're the only team to actually end up with more points than us. Firebird, who's in 4th, gets 27 points. So Firebird is, I think, catching really fastly up right now with Garuda. But we're only 8 points behind Sevilla now, ahead of Sevilla now, as he gained, I think, 6 points maybe on us this time. Ingledew drops really far down as we gain a lot of points on her. So she's actually an entire race behind us right now. Of course, the double point in the final race of the season. So a lot of changes can happen. Constructors-wise, we are in the lead with 11 points up to Eastwood, 34 points down to Firebird, and 30 to Garuda, and 33 to Firebird. So they seem like they are pretty far away now. Of course, there's 80 points on the line in the final race. So, unless I have to do really poorly now to lose to Firebird or Garuda, I think. Eastwood are still a contender, so I really need to look out for them right now. But let's just see what the chairman think. I guess I'm actually going to lose Happiness, even if I'm first still in both championship, just because I wasn't first in the constructors during the race, which I don't think I've been maybe only one time in the season, and that was one of my worst races, but I still finished first just because everyone else finished really badly as well. I actually gained Happiness, yes. I think it's like 6 or 7%. Thank God. Even though we came second, 1% only. Gained only 39,000 because we didn't actually complete our objective. I thought we were going to lose money if we didn't complete our objective, but apparently we did not. So yeah, new standings here. First in the championships with Alvarez, 11th Porter, he'll start in 10th next time. He's doing better and better for the team, he's getting a lot of points. Looking at the two teams, the three top teams have the front three riders. And then we have a rider in 11th, he's going to have a rider in 13th, and Garuda has a rider in 15th. So our best riders also do, we also have the best second rider. Then there's the Firebird team in the middle, in 5th and 6th, kind of two even riders. Pretty weird. So they're really consistent with both their drivers, but yeah, they don't have a rider who's really getting the wins often enough for them actually to be up there in the top of the standings, really close to the win. We thankfully have Alvarez for that point or two. But yeah, that is it now for this episode. I really hoped you guys enjoyed it, and I'll see you guys next time for the final two races, where we'll hopefully get promoted to the next series. Goodbye.